Good morning, students. I am Amit Singh, your host, and I welcome you all to the second tutorial on number system. So, as I've promised you in my previous video, in this video, we'll be covering up some reverse conversions, that is, binary to decimal, octal to decimal, and hexadecimal to decimal. And after that, we will take up binary addition, binary subtraction, binary division, and binary multiplications. Okay, so the first conversion that we are going to see today is binary to decimal conversion. Now, one small rule that you need to remember here is when you convert a binary number to decimal number, we need to multiply each binary digit with its positional value, which is in terms of powers of 2, right? And we need to start it from extreme right hand side. Okay, so the first step here is we will first copy this entire binary number down 1, 1, 1, 0, and 1. Now we need to add the powers, which will start from 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Next step, we will copy this binary number down, multiply by the base of binary is 2, so we will write 2, and what is power of 2? It is 4. Put a plus sign, copy the next digit down, 1, multiplied by 2 raised to the power 3. From where this 3 has come? There. Okay, so put a plus sign. Now copy the next digit down, 1, multiplied by base of binary, which is 2, and what is power of 2? It is 2. Put a plus sign, copy 0 down, and multiply it by the base of binary, which is 2, and what is power of 2? It is 1. Plus next digit is 1, multiplied by the base, which is 2, and raised to the power 0. Okay, now in order to multiply 1 with 2 raised to the power 4, we need to first calculate what is the value of 2 raised to the power 4. 2 raised to the power 4 means 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 4 times. And that is 2 into 2 is 4, 4 into 2 is 8, and 8 into 2 is 16. So we will write the next step, which is 1 multiplied by 16 plus next digit is 1, so we will write 1 multiplied by 2 raised to the power 3. Now 2 into 2 is 4, and 4 into 2 is 8, so this becomes 8. Plus copy the next digit down, multiplied by 2 raised to the power 2. Now 2 raised to the power 2 is 2 into 2, 2 times, which is equal to 4. Okay, now the next digit 0, we copy it down, multiplied by 2 raised to the power 1, which is 2 1 times, and that is equal to 2. Plus the next digit 1, multiplied by 2 raised to the power 0. Now any number that is raised to the power 0, its value is equal to 1. So 2 raised to the power 0 becomes 1. Okay, now we can multiply these digits and we can get the next step. So in the next step, we have 16 into 1, which is 16, plus 8 1 times is 8, so we write 8, put a plus sign. Now 4 1 times is 4, put a plus sign. Now anything multiplied by 0 will give you 0. So 0 plus 1 into 1 is 1. Now we need to add these numbers. In the next step, we have 16 plus 8 plus 4 plus 0 plus 1, which is equal to 29, and that is it. So this 29 of decimal number system is equal to 11101 of binary. That is it. Okay, so the next conversion that we are going to see today is octal to decimal conversion. And the rule remains the same here, that is, multiply each octal number with its positional value, which is in terms of powers of 8, beginning from extreme right hand side. Okay, so the first step is you copy this number down, this octal number, which is 223, and then we need to assign powers to it, starting from right hand side. So 0, 1 and 2. The next step, we need to copy this 2 down, multiplied by the base, which is 8. And what is power of 8? It is 2. Put a plus sign in between. Now the next step is copy this second digit down, 2, multiplied by the base 8, and what is power of 8? It is 1, plus the third and final digit 3, multiplied by the base, which is 8, and what is power of 8? It is 0. Right now, in order to perform this calculation, we need to first find out what is 8 raised to the power 2. And 8 raised to the power 2 here means 8 into 8 2 times, which is 64. Now this becomes 2, which I have copied down, multiplied by 8 raised to the power 2, which is 64. Put a plus sign after that. Now copy the next digit down, 2, multiplied by 8 raised to the power 1, which is 8 1 times only. So that is 8 only. Plus copy the next digit, which is 3, multiplied by 8 raised to the power 0. As I have told you in previous example, any number that is raised to the power 0, its value is equal to 1. So this becomes 3 multiplied by 1. Now we need to multiply these numbers to get the next step. Now 2 into 64 is 128, plus 2 into 8 is 16. So we write 16 here, plus 3 into 1 is 3. So we write 3 here. Now the final step, we need to add these numbers together, and we get 147, and that is it. So let's take the last conversion, which is hexadecimal to decimal conversion. Now we'll take a number 3D5A, base 16, that stands for hexadecimal number, which we want to convert to a base 10, which stands for decimal number. Now for the rule, now in order to convert a hexadecimal number to decimal, we need to multiply each digit of hexadecimal number with its positional value, which is in terms of power of 16, right, starting from extreme right hand side. Okay, so first step is, I'll copy this number down, 3 d 5 and my last digit is a. Now from the right hand side we need to assign the powers. So 0, we always start with 0. So 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now before we convert this number, before I write the next step, you must understand what is D and what is A, right? So we need to convert this D and this A into its equivalent and decimal number. Okay, so as I've already told you before, that A stands for 10, B stands for 11, C stands for 12, and D stands for 13, and so on, right? So first we will write these A and D in form of decimal number. So it becomes 3 raised to the power 3, which I've just copied, and the second digit D, which means 13. So this is 13 raised to the power 2, and we have 5. So I've written 5 raised to the power 1, and 10 here means A means 10. So I'll write 10 raised to the power 0. Right. Next step, we copy this number down, 13, multiply by the base. Now the base is 16. So this becomes 3 into 16 raised to the power 3. Put a plus sign. Then next number is 13. So we write 13 multiplied by the base, which is 16. So I write 16 there with power of 2. Right. Now copy the next digit down, 5 multiplied by 16 raised to the power 1 plus the last digit is 10. So it becomes 10 multiplied by the base, which is 16. So 16, and what's the power of 16? It's 0. Right. Now we need to first calculate what is 16 raised to the power 3 before we multiply it with 3. Okay. So 16 raised to the power 3 means 16 into 16 into 16 three times. And 16 into 16 is 256, and 256 into 16 is 4096. Okay, so I'll just write 4096 multiplied by 3 plus 13, which we have copied from above. Okay, so 16 raised to the power 2 is 256. So 16 raised to the power 2, so instead of that we will write its value, which is 256 plus 5 into 16 raised to the power 1, and 16 raised to the power 1 means 16 1 times, and that is equal to 16 plus 10 multiplied by 16 raised to the power 0. Now, I've told you this before also. So any number raised to the power 0, its value is equal to 1. So this becomes 10 into 1. Now, we need to perform this calculations. So, my next step is to multiply these individual digits. So, 3 into 4096, and that is 12,288. So I'll write 12,288. That's the product of 4096 multiplied by 3. Put a plus sign. Then we have 13 multiplied by 256, and that is equal to 3328, plus we have 16 into 5, which is equal to 80, plus last digit we have 10 into 1, which is equal to 10. Now we need to add all these digits together. So after adding all these digits, we get 15,706. Now this 15,706 of decimal number system is equal to 3D5A of hexadecimal. Okay, so after studying all those conversions, let us understand how does a computer perform various arithmetic operations. A computer understands only binary data. The data input by the user is first converted in binary code for processing. This processing may involve various kinds of arithmetic operations such as addition, multiplication, subtraction, or division. So, first user gives an instruction to the computer. The instruction may be in form of, let's say, 10 plus 12. Now, these digits 10 and 12 are first converted into its binary equivalent, and then the processing is taken. 10 and 12, these are decimal numbers, and we have already seen how to convert a decimal number into a binary number. So 10 is equal to 1010 binary, and 12 is equal to 1100 of binary. Now, after this conversion, after doing this conversion, computer performs addition. Right? Now, before adding these two numbers, let us understand what are the rules. And rules are quite simple ones. Okay, so when you add 0 and 0, you get 0, which is sum. And when you add 0 and 1, you get 1 as a sum. When you add 1 and 0, which is rule number 3, you get 1. Now, the fourth and most important rule here is when you add 1 and 1, you get 1 and 0. Here the 0 is sum and 1 is carry, which you add to the next digit, right? So we will add these numbers. 0 plus 0, rule number 1, gives you 0. 1 plus 0, rule number 3, gives you 1. 0 plus 1, rule number 2, gives you 1. Now, rule number 4, 1 plus 1 will give you 10. So, you write 0 and 1 is carry forwarded. And since we have no digits to add to this 1, so we copy this number down. And this is binary addition. Simple enough. Now, you can convert this number back to see what is the result. So this is 2 and 22. When you convert this binary number into decimal number, you get 22 back. Let's take up another arithmetic operation, which is binary subtraction. Let us understand how does a computer subtracts two numbers, right? So if I ask you, what is the answer of 12 minus 10? And before I write, you all will be shouting, sir, the answer is 2, and that is right. Okay, so let us understand, if we give the same instruction to the computer, how does a computer do the same arithmetic operation? Now, first computer will take this number, it will convert this into its binary equivalent, and that is equal to 1100. So this is 12, and then it will take the second number, which is 10, and it will convert this 10 of decimal number into its binary equivalent, which is 1010. Then the computer will subtract these two digits, right? Now, before we do this subtraction, we must first understand what are the rules. So, when you subtract 0 from 0, what you get is difference as, so the difference is 0. So, I'll write D, and we don't need to borrow anything, so I've not written anything there. Now, if you have 1 and you subtract 1 from it, I have one pen in my hand, and if you take this pen, what will I have? I'll have nothing. So 1 minus 1 will give you difference as 0, and there will be no borrowings. Now, the next digit is 1. If I have 1 and I subtract 0 from it, I have one pen in my hand, and you take nothing from me, so I'll be having one pen. So similarly, we get 1 as a difference here. 1 minus 0 will give you 1. Quite simple one. Now, the next one is most important one, that is when you have 0 and you want to subtract 1 from it. Now, if you have 0, in this case, so we need to borrow something from this, from the higher order side, and then we can subtract 1 from it. So when you subtract 0 from 1, 0 minus 1, so we need to borrow 1 from the higher order bits, and it will be 10 minus 1. And in binary, we know that 10 is equal to 1 plus 1. We have seen this before in when we were doing binary addition. So 1 plus 1 gives you 1, 0. So this, we can write it as 1 plus 1. Now, we can subtract 1 from this, which will be leftover is 1. So when you want to subtract 1 from 0, you need to borrow 1, and the difference that you get is 1, and I'll write borrow here, which is 1, right? So borrow is 1 and the difference is 1. So we need to keep these rules in mind before doing the subtraction. Okay, so 0 minus 0, which is rule number 1, will give you 0. 0 minus 1, which is rule number 4 here. So we need to borrow this, which is 10. And 10 minus 1, as I have shown you here, 10 minus 1 will give you 1 as a difference. And we will be left with 0 here, since we have already borrowed this one there. Okay, so for the next digit, 0 minus 0 will give you 0. And next, 1 minus 1 will give you 0. So what we are left here with 1, 0. And that 1, 0 is equal to 2 of decimal number. So was it that easy? Yeah. So after understanding binary addition and binary subtraction, let us understand how does a computer do binary multiplication. Now, the rules are quite simple ones. If I ask you a question, what is 9 into 5, you will say the answer is 45. Let us understand how does a computer perform this multiplication. Now, the computer will again, as we have seen, it will convert these numbers into binary equivalent. So the number becomes 9 is equal to 1001 and 5 is equal to 101. After converting into binary, then the computer will take up the operation of multiplication. How to multiply these two binary digits together? Now, the process is quite simple one, and all you need to know is the table of 1. And the rules are, when you multiply 0 with 0, you get 0 as a product. When you multiply 0 with 1, you get 0 as a product. When you multiply 1 with 0, you get 0 as a product. And last rule is, when you multiply 1 with 1, you get 1 as a product. Quite simple ones. Okay, so let's continue. We'll take the first digit of the multiplier and we will multiply with this entire number. So we will take the 1 and multiply this by 1, which will give us 1. 1 into 0 will give you 0. 1 into 0 will give you 0. 1 into 1 will give you 1. Now, put across. Now, take the second digit of the multiplier. 0, 1 times is 0. 0, 0 times 0. 0, 0 times 0 again. And 0 into 1 is 0 again. So we have done this. We have done this. Now let's take the last digit of the multiplier. Okay, so this is 1 multiplied by 1, which will be 1. 1 into 0 is 0. 1 into 0 is again 0. 1 into 1 is 1. Now we need to add these digits together. So 1 plus nothing plus nothing will give you 1. 0 plus 0 is 0, and 0 plus nothing is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0, and there's 1 left. So 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 plus 0 will give you 1. 0 plus 0 will give you 0, and last 1, because we don't have anything to add to it. So we are left here with 1 0 1 1 0 1, and when you convert this number, you get 45 back. Now let's take up the last topic for the day, and that is binary division. Now you don't need to remember any specific rules for binary division. If you know how to subtract to binary numbers, how to add to binary numbers, it is enough. Okay, so if I ask you What is answer of 26 divided by 5? So how you do this division? You take the number 26, divide this number by 5. 5 times is 25, and you get 1 as a remainder. Now let's understand how does a computer perform the same operation. So we'll take the number 26 and we will convert this into binary first, which will be equal to 11010. Right. Now we will divide this by the number 5, which when converted to binary is 101. Now the process of division, binary division, starts. Now 101, 3 digits, so 1 times is 101. Now we need to subtract these 2 digits, so we need to subtract 1 from 0, and for doing that we will take 1, borrow, which will be 10. Now we have already seen that 10, when you subtract 1 from it, you get 1 as a difference. So I write 1 here, and here we are left with 0. So 0 minus 0 will give you 0, and 1 minus 1 will give you 0. Now we will copy the next digit down, which is 1, and now we cannot divide this 11 by 101, so it will divide how many times? 0 times. So we write 000, since 0 into 101 is 000, so we will subtract. What we are going to get as a difference is 1 and 1. Now the next step, you copy this 0 down, and again we will divide this number by 101. So 1 times 101, and we will do the subtraction here. Now again same thing, 0, we have to subtract 1 from 0, so we will borrow this 1 here, that is 10, and we are left here with 0. So according to the rule of subtraction, 10 minus 1 will give you 1 as a difference, and what we are left here with, 0 minus 0 will give you 0, 1 minus 1 will give you 0, and this is the remainder what we are getting here. And 101 is the quotient which is equal to 5, and with that we come to the end of first chapter, number system. Hope you guys have understood the topics. Keep revising things. Hope to see you soon. Till then, stay safe, stay home. Bye bye.